Okay, dear students, now we will deal about whatever your halogens and halorins topic. So that we are going to come in your whatever first round on 30 October. Okay, so see here in halogens and halorins. So whenever you are dealing with halogens and halorins, so very much here important discussion. Okay, regarding your all. Whatever your board exams and competitive exam, okay. Halogens and halorin. Already you studied this such type of compound, such type of what convergence examples, okay. So here, whenever you are studying this halogens and halorin, you must know your GOC topic. So what that GOC? General organic chemistry. What beta? General organic chemistry. So it is in general organic chemistry. So you must know that all effects, whatever inductive effect, then mesomeric effect, electromeric effect. So here, all these effects, hyperconjugation, resonance, here, whatever these basic terminology present in GOC, you must know. Because it is the basic things for your halogens and halorin and your all related topics of organic. Thereafter, your this topic hydrocarbons. So hydrocarbons, you studied what preparations of hydrocarbons. Then in that mostly you studied what alkanes. What alkanes? Then your alkenes. Then your what alkynes. Okay. So alkanes preparation. Then your alkenes preparation. How we use whatever your rules, then which rules? Markovnikov rule, okay. Markovnikov rule, then what here? Anti-Markovnikov rule we discuss, okay. Then in the preparation of alkynes, we use what? We use one reagent that is sodamide, okay. So that also it is continuing your. This topic halogens and halor means somewhere in convergence, whatever your convergence, organic convergence, halogens and halorin, these things, these all things are important. Means these 11 basic topics you must, whatever you must do study on that general organic chemistry or hydrocarbons in that alkanes, their preparation, then their properties. Very, very much important here whenever you are dealing with this topic. Okay, 12th, first, 12th, your first organic topic. So, these are what basic criteria for the preparation of these halogens and halorins. Okay, so if you do this correctly, accurately, perfectly, then also organic chemistry it will easy for you. Okay. And you have to continuously for the means you must continue with whatever your conversion, whatever your preparations, okay. Then your aromaticity also here, okay. So like that small small things very very much important here. So now without wasting time, we will start whatever what we are to discussing here in halogens and halorin topic, okay. So see here. In halogens and halorins. So here you must know what is the first thing. So that first thing beta here. All monohalogens, dihalogens. Okay. Monohalogens. Then what beta? Dihalogens. Okay. Monohalogens, dihalogens. Then what? Compounds containing sp3 cx bond. Yes, compounds containing what? Sp3 hybridized c bond x. Okay, c bond x. Okay, sp3 hybridized. Okay, here these things are very much important. So which are those here sp3 hybridized? So see here that you already discussed this all whatever sp3 hybridized. Okay, so see here Suppose I will write like this, CH3CH2Cl. So whatever this carbon atom is, what, sp3 hybridized. Why it is sp3? Because it is bonded with singly bond. Okay, thereafter, suppose if you are dealing with means what we call as a simple, as a what simple, alkyl halide. What beta? Alkyl halide. Okay, if I am dealing with this, what we can say, small a part, if I will dealing with allylic, what, allylic halide. So allylic halide, what will be the formula? Yes, as like this, CH2 double bond CH, CH2Cl. So whatever this carbon atom, it is directly attached to this halogen. So this also what, beta, sp3 hybridized. So we are dealing with what, compounds containing sp3 CH bond. Okay, so these small things are very much important in the preparation of organic chemistry. It is the beauty of this chemistry. Okay, so see here, this one allylic halide means after this losing this Cl, okay, after losing this Cl, what will happen? CH double bond CH2 plus. So what we call allylic halide, sorry, allylic carbocation. What with the allylic carbocation? Okay, so this thing is very, very much important here. And suppose here this chlorine atom is evolved, so what will happen? CH3 CH2 delta plus. So what we call it as a ethyl carbocation. So whatever this carbocation and all these allylic and benzylic, you studied in where? In your general organic chemistry. So that's why I told you have a good command on these topics. Okay, whatever your GOC and all bond fission, you know bond fission, heterolytic and homolytic bond fission. Okay, understood. These are all allylic. And here I will like to tell you one thing here regarding a benzylic also. See part benzylic. So see your benzylic halide, how can you write benzylic halide? Or we can say, see, benzylic halide as like this, benzening with what, CH2Cl. okay, this what here, benzyl chloride. What beta? Benzyl chloride. And after losing this, okay, so after losing this, what will happen? CH2, yes, benzene ring, CH2 plus Cl minus. Okay, so what we call here, yes, benzylic carbocation. Understood? So very, very much important here this part. And you discuss, we all discuss whatever, all this carbocation stability order also. Okay, so accordingly that they will behave according to their stability order. Okay, some are also like this, that are what, sp2 hybridized. So see here how they will react like a sp2 hybridized. So see here, in sp2 hybridized, benzene ring with what, directly your halogen, any X. So X is, as you know, chloro, bromo, iodo. Okay, so X means sp3, whatever this carbon atom is what, sp2 hybridized carbon atom. Okay, if you are dealing with sp2, if you are dealing with sp2 CX bond. Okay, so this whatever small thing you must know here. Okay, now suppose if you are dealing with like this, one of the aliphatic, what, aliphatic, your, yes, vinylic halide. So CH2 double bond CHCl. So it will what, remove like this, this what, beta? Yes, vinyl chloride. And after losing this, what will happen? CH2 double bond CH delta plus. What we call this? Vinyl carbocation. What? Vinyl carbocation. Okay, so very, very much important is also, like this, like that previous, whenever we are discussing this all NCERT content, okay, you must have your NCERT book strictly, okay, and then accordingly you have to do preparation from NCERT first, okay. So thereafter, so many important things, okay. Then nomenclature also you have to do, okay. Then what intakes question you can ask directly if you not know, okay. If you are if you don't know how to write IUPAC nomenclature, you can ask directly to me, okay. Then here preparation of alcohols, so all these methods of preparation of alcohols which are there, yes, from PX3, PX5, all are important, okay. So see, from alcohols also, then by free radical, then by Sandmeer reaction, okay. So much important here, this Sandmeer reaction also, okay. How your aniline, it will react. So see, I will like to tell you here one example regarding what, beta? Yes, Sandmeer reaction. Okay, so see here in Sandmeer reaction, what will form? Like this, your what? Yes, aniline here. And this aniline, when you apply with this diazotization, means what? NaNO2 plus HCl at 0 to 5 degrees Celsius. So we can prepare such type of condition in our lab also. And we done already in previous batches. Okay, so whatever this diazotization, you will get what here? One salt. Okay, so that salt is what, beta? Yes, N2 plus Cl minus, we call it as a what? Benzene. Yes, benzene diazonium salt. What, beta? Benzene diazonium salt. And if you done here Cu2Cl2, then Cu2Cl2, what it will form? Yes, you will get what? Chlorobenzene along with N2 plus HCl, along with what? N2 plus HCl. So basically in organic chemistry, you no need to write whatever byproducts. You have to focus on only on product. Okay. So like that Sandmeer reaction, it is there. Okay. So many things are here. You already studied this. Okay. So then what is the role of Bi2 in CCl4? Okay. Then also is here in text question also present. Page number 289, so that also you solve, okay. So we will solve from this few question, other you solve, okay. Means if you are dealing with any content or any subject, you must practice before exam at least 5 to 6 times, then only you will be confident about that content and about that subject also, okay. So this thing you always keep in mind whenever you are dealing with whatever content with exam, for exam, then you have to must practicing 5 to 6 times, okay. And more than that, then only you will be what, confident on that particular content, on that particular subject, okay. So practice is very much important in organic chemistry. Okay, in physical chemistry, some are formula based questions also there, but there also theoretical background is much important. Okay, theoretical background. Without theoretical background, you can't solve whatever your numerical. Okay, so see here, 10.5 we will solve here. Okay, so see they gave here like this, OH plus what? SOCl2. So what will form here? As you know, role of this thionic chloride. Yes, you will get what? OH is replaced by Cl. Along with what? SO2 plus Cl. If you means no any need to write this byproduct, only we have to write what? Beta product. Okay. So we will solve here. This first you solve, then second. So see, if you are dealing with this second, say you're this benzene ring. Okay. Then what they gave? CH2, CH3, and here what? Here they gave NO2. So how they will? They gave here what? Br2 in heat, or we can say what? UV light. Okay, they give UV light here also. Then at the which position your bromine will go. So this thing, when it will come, if you what practice of GOC, then and then only you will solve this. Okay, so see here, so that's why I'm saying, from first onward also I'm saying, your whatever this part, GOC and hydrocarbon, is very, very much important here. Okay, so these are what your product. At the benzylic position only your bromine will attach. Okay, so do accordingly. If any doubt, you can ask during preparation. Like that, so many things you can solve here, but time also, okay, your time also precious. Okay, then you have to do self-study. Okay, then if any doubt, we are there, we are always ready to help. Okay, anytime. So after that, basic whatever physical properties, melting and boiling point also very, very much important here. That also do. Okay, so basically in organic chemistry, so see here, one they gave you page number 292. So see this page, nucleophilic substitution. Okay, so whatever this nucleophilic substitution, this chart, so you prepare this chart very well, then accordingly you can what you can do very, very much what so much conversion you can do on the base of this chart. Okay, so see they gave H2O, then NaOR, ether, how we can form alkyl iodide, we can form amine, how we can form, okay, KCN from cyanide, how we can form alkyl cyanide, how we can form what alkyl isocyanides, that also they gave. Then how we can form nitrite with the help of KNO2, then what HgNO2, sodium nitrite also there. Okay, either KNO2 or sodium NO2, NaNO2 we can use, silver nitrite also there. Okay, so these are what very, very much important regarding your halokings and haloring. Okay, so many reactions. I mean, basically this topic is what so many lectures we have to you either studied this lecture, whatever this topic, haloalkanes and haloarene. In that, small things are very, very much important. Again, in that word, yes, ambidentate, or we can say what? Ambient. Yes. Ambient nucleophile. What? Having a two donor side, we call it as what? Ambient or ambident, or we can say what? Ambident nucleophile. Ambident nucleophiles having a two donor sites. Okay, then reactions of haloalkanes and haloarenes are also very, very much important. Then we are dealing with what very much important, that is SN1 reaction and SN2 reactions. So that SN1 and SN2 reaction with either it is of first order kinetics, second order kinetics, that you have to say. Okay, then if they are what first order kinetic, second order, okay, then we are dealing with examples for SN1, what tertiary alkyl halide used, for SN2, what primary alkyl halide is used. Okay, then like that, so many means stereochemistry of that backside attack or front side attack. So like that, very, very much small things are very much important here. Okay, now your chirality means optical activity also important here. Okay, optical activity, then plane polarized light, so that all definition you have to do from 296 page. Okay, chirality, then small definition, chirality, asymmetric chromatin. Okay, a chiral means what? Understood. With the help of this whatever in-text questions you have to solve, the reaction with metals with the Grignard reagents also there. Okay, then all that reactions of haloarenes, reactions of haloarenes means Friedel-Crafts alkylation, then Friedel-Crafts acylation also very much important. Okay, then what would you fitting reaction. Okay, so see here, Wood's reaction, okay, Wood's reaction, then what we are saying, Wood's fatigue, Woods Fittig reaction, okay, only Fittig reaction also there, means all our reaction, means no any skip, we can't skip here, whatever all contents are very very much important, only you have to skip for this CBSE board preparation is what, yes, that is polyhalogen compounds, okay, polyhalogen compounds and freons, DDT, for only what CBSE board exam you have to skip, you have to miss, they delete it, okay, other all are important and do prepare accordingly, if any doubt will come you can ask anytime, okay, you can share your doubts on WhatsApp also, okay, so these are what I told here, deleted topic, so deleted topic is what, polyhalogen compounds and all, whatever DDT, freons, then your chloroform, CHCl2, these all are what deleted syllabus for only CBSE board preparation, other all competitive exam, it is there, it is present, okay, so thank you very much, I hope you understood all this and whatever you have to do is, means all we discuss here, whatever important thing, so you do accordingly and what success is yours only. Thank you.